Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending on where you are in the world. I'm Thomas Trombley with the Windows Wire, here to catch you up with the latest and greatest Windows client news, especially around update management. Let's get rolling. Aria Carley continues to put out blog goodness this month, this time announcing two upcoming features that will make the Windows Update experience better for users of managed devices. First, if you're using Windows Update for Business, you'll soon be able to brand Windows Update notifications with your company name. Instead of seeing notifications requiring action from, quote, your organization, your end users will be able to clearly see your company name as the source of the required action. To try this experience today, simply join a device to the Windows Insider Program beta channel, configure a compliance deadline, the number one recommended Windows Update policy, by the way, and make sure your Azure AD tenant name is configured and is less than 32 characters long. Second, if you're using Configuration Manager, a huge new capability is coming your way. Soon you'll be able to benefit from the native Windows Update orchestration and end user experience seen by home devices and devices managed by Windows Update for Business. End users will see the familiar notifications and settings experience that they see at home, but with the ability to leverage active hours, reserve storage, and other great update experiences. Super exciting. You can find demos to these new features and more information on how they work by visiting aka.ms/seamlessupdates. This past week saw another edition of Tech Community Live, this time with the spotlight on Microsoft Endpoint Manager, or MEM. Over the course of four back-to-back AMAs, experts answered questions on managing Windows endpoint security, improving the end user experience with endpoint analytics, and Linux management. This will be a quarterly series for Endpoint Manager, and you can watch last week's event on demand at aka.ms/tcl/endpointmanager. Now let's switch gears from what's new and talk about an existing but noteworthy resource that can inform when and how you roll out updates across your organization. We just celebrated the 1-year anniversary of Windows Release Health on the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Here's my teammate Mabel to share a little more. Mabel?
If you're not familiar with Windows Release Health, it's a one-stop shop to learn more about Windows updates, and it's localized in 10 languages. You can see all the supported versions of Windows, details about Windows 11 rollout, and known issues. This public experience is available in Microsoft Docs at aka.ms/WindowsReleaseHealth. For IT admins, 1 year ago, we introduced a parallel experience in the health section of the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Designed to help those managing updates for their organizations, Windows Release Health in the Admin Center offers more technical detail around known issues. Admins can also see announcements about important changes or new resources related to Windows servicing and updates on the Message Center. And the best of all, you can set up notifications to receive emails about all these changes. If you want to know how to do that, please check our demo video.
Log into the Microsoft 365 Admin Center to easily set up your email preferences. From the Home tab, select Show All and select Health from the navigation menu. Under Health, select Message Center. Select Preferences, then navigate to the Email tab within the Preferences flyout. Check the box next to your primary email address. You can receive email notifications at up to 2 additional email addresses. To set this up, select Other Email Addresses and add the desired addresses. Next, choose the type of emails you'd like to receive. We recommend Send Me Emails for Major Updates to ensure you don't miss important information. You can also select to receive a weekly digest about specific Microsoft 365 services and products, such as Windows. Select Save to confirm your choices, and you're done.
Thanks, Mabel. As we wrap up this edition of the Windows Wire, I want to note that we're always interested in your questions, thoughts, and feedback. For example, last month's event, Windows Powers the Future of Hybrid Work, well, it generated a lot of interest in Windows Auto Patch and a few questions. At a high level, Windows Auto Patch provides a solution for those companies seeking a more automated approach to deploying updates. Working with the Auto Patch team, we've updated both the announcement and FAQ to provide additional clarity around how the service works. There are no changes to Patch Tuesday. Those who want or need to manage and customize the update experience using tools such as Windows Update for Business, Microsoft Endpoint Manager, and WSUS can continue to do so as they do today. Since I mentioned questions and feedback, I want to close that we're here for you every third Thursday with Windows Office Hours on the Microsoft Tech Community. The next one is May 19th, so be sure to RSVP and add it to your calendars at aka.ms/Windows Office Hours. That's it for this edition of the Windows Wire. Thank you for watching.